This is part one of parabolas. We define quadratic functions and we graph the following two parabolas. Also, we talk about the vertex point and the axis of symmetry of a parabola. In this video, we're going to be doing some graphing, but first let's talk about a quadratic function. So a quadratic function is a function that can be written in the form f of x plus ax squared plus bx plus c, or you could write that as y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, where the coefficients a, b, and c are real numbers, and a is not equal to 0. Now, when you graph a quadratic function, you get what's called a parabola. So here's some examples of some quadratic functions. F of x equals x squared. Remember, you could replace f of x with y on all of these. And notice that you don't see the coefficients a, b, and c, but there is a coefficient of x squared. It would be 1. And in this example, f of x equals x squared, b is 0 and c is 0. So there's just that single term. And then we have several more. X squared minus 1, x squared plus 2x, 1 half x squared, 2x squared minus 3, etc. You'll notice this one, f of x equals in parentheses x minus 4 squared. If you multiplied that out, you'd have x squared minus 8x plus 16, so that's also in the correct form. It means you can put it in that form. Same thing with this last one, f of x equals 3x plus 1 squared plus 5. But what's important in all of these is that there is an x squared term. Okay, I'm going to take the most basic quadratic function, f of x equals x squared, or, of course, you could think of that as y equals x squared, and we're going to graph it. So let's make a little chart over here. We'll pick some numbers for x, and I suggest you pick some positive and some negative numbers. So how about negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2? Those are four numbers. Remember, you could choose any numbers you want for x. And we want to know what x squared is, because this is y is x squared. So if x is negative 2, then y would be 4. Negative 2 times negative 2. When it's negative 1, we would get 1. 0 squared is 0. 1 squared is 1. And 2 squared is 4. So those are 4 points on this graph. So let's go over here and do that. We've got 0, 0. We have 1, 1. And let's see, we have 2, 4. And let's just see, what about if I did another one, 3? 3, it would be up 9, so I'd go over 3, and it would be around here. Okay, so if I didn't put some negative numbers, I may think, well, maybe this just, you know, keeps on going like that, but let's check out some of these other numbers. I have negative 2, 4, and I have negative 1, 1, what about if I would have put in negative 3? I would have negative 3, 9. And what happens is if you put enough dots in here and you connect the dots, you end up getting a graph that looks like this. And that's what a parabola looks like. It's a curvy thing. Now, notice there's some symmetry here across the y-axis. Like if you look on the right-hand side of the y-axis, if you sort of had a mirror and looked through to the other side, it should look exactly the same. Of course, I'm sketching it, so it's not perfect, but you get the basic idea. This invisible line that I've dotted, this is called the axis of symmetry. Actually, I'm going to run out of room. Axis of symmetry. And actually, you could write an equation for the axis of symmetry. What line is that? Well, that's the line that is the y-axis. And remember what the equation of the y-axis is? It's x equals 0. So that's the equation for the axis of symmetry. Every parabola has an axis of symmetry. It also has what is called a vertex point, this place right here, where it sort of changes. So notice on the left side it's kind of going down, and that's where it changes, it starts curving upward. And that point there is called the vertex of the parabola. And in this case, that's the ordered pair 0, 0. Now, what's always true is if you could find the vertex, that is the value for the x, if you're talking about a function. So if the vertex has 0 for the x-coordinate, then the axis symmetry, the equation will be x equals 0. If this would have been a 1 for the x-coordinate, it would be x equals 1. It'll be the same number. All right, so for every parabola that's a quadratic function, like this, there's a vertex point, there's the axis of symmetry, and the cool thing about the axis of symmetry is this. If you know where this axis of symmetry is, and you plot some points to the right of it, you could just go the same amount of spaces on the other side to get another point. So if I had gotten this point 2, 4, I could just say, well, that if I go two spaces over to the axis of symmetry, I go two spaces to the left, I have another point. So that's one of the uses of putting in your axis of symmetry. Something else we notice about this parabola is that it's going up, right? In other words, it's like a U shape going up. Sometimes there are some parabolas going down, and we're going to be doing some problems like that as well. So I'm going to call this f of x equals x squared, or y equals x squared. I'm going to call this my basic parabola. So it's important that you sort of can easily get these ordered pairs right here. Okay, so if you're doing y equals x squared, remember, just put in some numbers like from negative 2 to 2, and you're squaring it, and you get these basic ordered pairs, negative 2, 4, negative 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, and 2, 4. All right, we're going to do another quadratic function now. Okay, let's do this one, f of x equals x squared minus 4. Remember, you could think of that as y equals x squared minus 4. So let's again plug in some numbers for x. How about the same 5 we started with in the last one? Okay, but this time, instead of just doing x squared, we have to do x squared minus 4. So we're going to do negative 2 squared is 4, and then minus 4 gets you to 0. Negative 1 squared would be 1, minus 4 is negative 3. 0 squared is 0, minus 4 is negative 1. I'm sorry, it's negative 4. 1 squared minus 4 is negative 3. 2 squared minus 4 is 0. And 4, whoops, I don't know why I put that 4 down there. That's all I meant to do is go to negative 2 to 2. So let's graph those. We've got negative 2, 0, negative 1, negative 3, 0, negative 4, 1, negative 3, and 2, 0. All right, again, let's go ahead and plug in. What if it was not 3 for x? That would be 9 minus 4, or 5. So I'd have 3, 5. And if I have negative 3 and I square it and subtract 4, I also get 5. So I've got some more ordered pairs, and then we sort of smoothly try to connect these. Remember, this goes on forever. And again, we have a parabola. Now, when you look at it, notice again, we have this axis of symmetry right here, which is, again, the y-axis, where x equals 0. The vertex point is different. The vertex point is down here. What point is that right there? That's 0, negative 4. So we've got 0, negative 4 for my vertex point. Notice again, the x coordinate of the vertex is the same as the value for x in the axis of symmetry. Now, if you look at this graph and you compare it to the previous one we did, let's look at that real quickly. Notice it looks sort of the same, except this one is way up here starting at 0, 0. So the graph I just did, really, all of these ordered pairs were just moved down 4 units. So if I was going to do x squared minus 4, y equals x squared minus 4, it's like every ordered pair gets moved down. So I had the 0, negative 4. This one gets moved down 4 spaces. And on the other side, this one gets down leave down 4 spaces. And this one gets moved down 4 spaces. And if I were to graph that, this purple one was the graph of y equals x squared minus 4. Okay, we're going to go on to the next video so that we can learn a little bit more about that. But to begin with, we just got the basic idea of what it looks like if you graph one of these quadratic functions. So we graphed the two, f of x equals x squared and f of x equals x squared minus 4.